mentioned police officers, and they have gotten such a bad rap, and yet they cannot all be bad. They must mostly be good, and the training has been such a big issue. What do you think we need to do now to help those officers get out of the situation we're in?
Again, I think there needs to be additional training, but I think the biggest underlying problem that we are confronting is dealing with mental illness and our social service programs. The budget for social service programs has been cut by 5% over the last few years with the budgetary issues. But I think it's vital, especially today, that we look at opening up a new facility for the mentally ill where they can go get their meds. Marty Chavez, when he was the mayor of the city, and the council voted and passed a bill for Kendra's Law. The courts threw that bill out, saying it was unconstitutional. We've got to go back and look at all the underlying problems that also exist. And again, we need to work with the men and women that work for the Albuquerque Police Department to assure them that they are getting the proper training that they need, because I think the biggest scar that they carry with them every day to work is the John Hyde killings, where two police officers were killed by John Hyde, who was mentally ill, and 300 individuals in our community. So it's a tough balance, because we need to work with those men and women, and they want to come home to their families each and every night.
So in terms, Councilor Garduño, was there anything you wanted to mention that I didn't get to?
Well, I think one of the things that we need to remember is that although we've listened or we've heard a lot of the concerns that the community has had over a number of years, I want to thank Council President Sanchez for clearing the agenda at the last council meeting and making sure that we heard from the community in a more detailed, more discussion format. I was able to get a hold of some folks that I work with almost on a daily basis, and we were able to find four representatives of those communities that talked about really important issues, things that a lot of us don't hear about because they're part of communities that either we don't interact with or don't listen to, quite frankly. And I think it's true that we need to make sure that homelessness is an issue that we need to deal with. Mental illness is a very serious issue we need to really work on.
Do you have any specific ideas for what the council could do for homelessness, for example?
Well, you know, I just recently, two council meetings ago, proposed that we up the amount of money for workforce / affordable housing. Mm-hmm. And that was not passed. Unfortunately, it was actually vetoed. It came back, so that now I'm trying to see if we can put some more money into that line item, if you will. At one time, we had close to $10 million in that line item. Last year, it was $1.5 million. I was able to get it up to $2.2 million. That's the kind of thing that we need to do. Mental illness is another issue that is citywide, and I think
we should require people to take their meds or face involuntary commitment?
Well, I don't think so. I mean, we can't just sort of say, take your meds. I think we need to have a program, something that helps folks understand why these things are happening and why they need to do that. But I don't think we can just sort of throw people out. That happened, and I'm probably going to get some flack for this, but that happened during the Reagan administration when mental illness was considered just sort of a fringe idea. People were thrown out on the streets just willy-nilly. People were just in places that you wouldn't believe. I know the psychiatric hospital here in Albuquerque was closed. People were walking the streets not knowing what to do because they had been used to a fail-safe, a net that they were able to rely on, and now they can't. Those are the kinds of things that we're elected to do. We're elected to make sure that our community is taken care of. This is not just economic development, as important as that is. And it's not just bringing Tesla into town, as important as that is. It's also making sure that our citizens are taken care of. We need to know, or they need to know, that we've got their backs.
You mentioned Tesla. Councilor Sanchez, do you think that Tesla would look at this Department of Justice report and say, we're going to cross Albuquerque off the list now?
Hopefully that will not be the case. I think Albuquerque's culture, the people that live here, our city, would be a great location for Tesla to locate.
But would you blame them for saying, look, this city looks like it's a mess? Well, we don't want to go there.
I mean, I can understand where they're coming from, looking at the pictures, looking at what has occurred. But again, I've lived here my entire life. I think it's the best city in America to live in, and things will only get better. And if we can welcome Tesla to our community and bring 5,000 to 6,000 new jobs to our city, it would be wonderful for the corporation of Tesla, and it would be wonderful for our city.
Thank you both for staying with us late for this Web Extra.
Sure.
Thank you.